You might have heard recently that La Niña has ended for now. And you might have heard it could come back later this year. Now, a lot of people might be wondering, well, what is La Niña anyway? Well, I'm glad you asked. Incredibly, La Niña is literally cold water on the sea surface between Tahiti and South America. You might be wondering, well, what's that got to do with Australia? Well, the story of how cold seawater more than 10,000 kilometres away drives floods in Australia is one of the most extraordinary tales in science. And it all begins with some fishermen in Peru hundreds of years ago. I'm serious. So centuries ago, fishermen in Peru noticed every few years the ocean temperatures there would warm around Christmas time and fish would go off the bite. They called the warm current El Niño de Navidad, which means Christmas child in Spanish, or El Niño for short. Eventually, scientists worked out that when El Niño was around, there was often drought in Australia. And when waters were cool off South America, there was often floods in Australia. The cool phase was dubbed La Niña, meaning the girl, El Niño's sister. So what does that have to do with rain in Australia? What happens is the cooler water on the South American side of the Pacific makes the trade winds stronger. Now those winds, which blow from east to west across the Pacific, push water towards Australia and Indonesia. Those waters, which have warmed along the way, literally pile up off the coast of Australia and Indonesia. In fact, so much water piles up in a La Niña year, like the one we're having at the moment, that recently the sea level in the Western Pacific has risen by about 20 centimetres. Those warm waters evaporate and form rain-bearing clouds, and then the easterly winds coming off the ocean bring the rain to eastern Australia. If there's enough warm water and the weather patterns are in just the right place, La Niña rains in Australia can be nothing short of biblical. In 2010, one of the strongest La Niñas ever recorded set in. In late November 2010, rain began falling in Queensland. It rained so much that by January, 1 million square kilometres of Queensland was underwater and 3/4 of the state was declared a disaster zone. So much water was evaporated out of the ocean and dumped on Queensland that the world's sea level dropped by 0.5 centimetre. That's a lot of rain. This past La Niña year hasn't been quite as wet, but not by much. Rain and flood records have been smashed this year, particularly in New South Wales, and Lismore has suffered arguably the greatest natural disaster Australia has seen since Cyclone Tracy. La Niña has eased for now. In other words, the waters off Tahiti have warmed a bit, slowing down the rain-bearing effects. For now. But scientists are getting good at predicting when La Niña is on the way again, and there are signs it might return for a third year in a row this spring. If La Niña does return, there's a good chance rain will be on the way yet again.